Good morning, Nick and Jack family. It's time for our morning announcements on this thoughtful Thursday. If you will, at this time, please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Students, at this time, join me for a moment of silent reflection, and I want you to think about how you can make today a great day. All right, what's on today's menu? Today we have cheese pizza, pepperoni pizza, barbecue pulled pork sandwich, chicken tender salad, vegetarian pasta salad, tossed side salad, and barbecue baked beans. Students, it's now time for Becoming Bilingual with Mrs. Braswell.
Buenos dias, Nick and Jack Braves. I'm excited to share with you that today, September 15th, marks the beginning of Hispanic Heritage Month. Like Black History Month in February and Women's History Month in March, Hispanic Heritage Month educates, celebrates, and honors the contributions of an often underrepresented or marginalized group of people. In this case, American citizens whose ancestors come from Spain, Mexico, the Caribbean, Central, and South America. Hispanic is the term we use when talking about people who speak Spanish. There are 21 countries in the world from which Hispanic people originate. They include Argentina, Bolivia, Chile, Colombia, Costa Rica, Cuba, Dominican Republic, Ecuador, El Salvador, Equatorial Guinea, Guatemala, Honduras, Mexico, Nicaragua, Panama, Paraguay, Peru, Puerto Rico, Spain, Uruguay, and Venezuela. At our school, we have many Hispanic staff and students. I am from Mexico. We have other staff members who are from Puerto Rico, República Dominicana, Venezuela, and Costa Rica, to name a few. Last week, I was in a classroom and I met a student who's originally from Panama. While we all speak Spanish, culturally, there are many differences among Hispanics. Over the next few weeks, I will be highlighting the cultures of various students and staff so we can learn together during Hispanic Heritage Month. You may have noticed that the intro into this segment featured a different song from last week. The Spanish word for music is música. Música is an important part of all Hispanic culture. Salsa, merengue, tango, bachata, reggaeton, tejano, mariachi, banda, and cumbia are just a few of the different types of Hispanic music. La canción de la semana, or this week's song of the week, was México Lindo y Querido by Alejandro Fernández. This song is considered Mexican mariachi music. Keep an ear out for a new song each week. Be sure to come to Multicultural Night tonight from 6:30 to 8:30. There will be food, crafts, and entertainment from around the world. Hasta la próxima.
Students, stay tuned for a special message from our Nickajack Elementary Foundation.
Good morning, Nickajack Braves. Wow, you guys are getting so good at that, but I love to hear it. So one more time, good morning, Nickajack Braves. That sounds fantastic. I can tell that you have your energy. And just so you know, again, I am Ryan Roy, and I was so excited to be on campus last Friday. I saw some of you at FBI Dads. I was walking through the halls, and I got to wave and see a whole bunch of you. So it was really great to be in the school. But I have to tell you, we need your energy more than ever. Why? Because this is the last week of the Back the Jack campaign. Can I get a Back the Jack? One, two, three. That's right. You guys are doing so well at that. You guys told me that in the hallways when I saw you. I was so excited to be at the school. But guess what? We need you to go home and tell your parents that this is the last week that they could back the jack. I know last week we had a pajama party and we ended up having a second pajama party this past Monday. I hope you all really enjoyed that. Next week, the entire school, when we hit our goal, is going to have a glow stick party next Friday. How many of you want a glow stick party in your classroom? Raise your hand and wave them like crazy. I love when you do that. So go home, tell mom and dad to back to jack once again. And I want you to know there are some classes in the leaderboard. I don't know them off the top of my head right now, but some of you probably know. The classrooms that have the top participation in the grade level that you're in is going to get a donut party also next Friday. And I'm going to add a little bonus. I'm going to deliver the donuts. So I'm going to pop into your classroom, say hello, bring the donuts so that you can have your glow stick party and your donut party. Does that sound awesome? Yes or yes? Yes or yes? I'm excited. Go tell mom and dad to back to jack. You've done a fantastic job. Your teachers were rewarded last week with an amazing lunch. And we are so excited for all that the monies are going to do for you this school year. Go home and back to jack.
Well, students, wasn't that a great video? But I know you really want to know which classes are in the lead for that donut party that I know each of you wants to earn. But guess what? There's still time if your class is not on this list. And it's okay. Keep bringing those monies in so that we can meet our goal of $150,000. So here we go. In kindergarten, we have Milovich, first grade Stanley, second grade Vitakovic, third grade Kumar, fourth grade Nelson, fifth grade Felix, multi-grades Robbins, and we have a little competition here in dual language, Miss Agrinsoni's class. Students, I know that each of you wants us to win that glow party, so have your families bring that money in so we can all celebrate together. All right, tonight is Multicultural Night. I know Mrs. Breswell told you, I've been reminding you, just remember tonight to join us. Can't wait to see you at 6 o'clock. All right, and students, if you are in fourth and fifth grade and interested in joining the math team, please get applications to Mrs. Harrison by Monday, September 19th. But don't worry, if you need an application, just drop by and see her and let her know that you're interested. But get the applications in on time, and that's for our fourth and fifth grade students. All right, next Friday is our first STEM day of the year. So excited. And Kona Ice will be here also. So remember, $3, $4, $5, or $6 will get you that special treat. All right, and then the next week is fall break. That's right, a whole week off at the end of this month. So I want you to rest your brains and minds and get ready to come back for a wonderful time of learning. All right, students, now join me in our B3 chant. I am a Nickajack Brave. I am a respectful, responsible role model, and I am ready to learn. Positive thoughts plus positive actions equals positive results. Make it a great day. The choice is yours. Have a thoughtful Thursday, my friends.